Hey, welcome back to Lasco Ford. Now we're going to be taking a look at the 2020 Ford Expedition. Not any regular Expedition. We're going to be taking a look at the Expedition Limited with a stealth package on top of that. Ready? Here we go. Let's start in the front like we always do. Make our way around. We'll look at the inside, the outside, every different way to go about it. Here we go. Well, first of all, I love having the blacked out accents, like the piano black grille, but it's not piano black anymore. It's got all this metallic flake that's built into it, which is called a gate black, which puts that metallic back into it. We haven't really seen a whole lot of this since 2015 when tuxedo black went away, and now they came back with not just piano black, the newer version of it, the gate black. On the back side of your headlights, you're gonna be taking a look at a quad beam LED headlamp. That is gonna be a major difference. So you gotta see these two right here and pay attention to that, because it's not gonna be found in an XLT package. XLT package is gonna give you that projector beam look, right? So you'll have a very similar look to this, but when you go to the Limited and you go to the Stealth package, you're gonna get some major upgrades. Got a book of reasons of why the Expedition is better than a lot of the competition, but at this level, game over, right? Start by taking a look at the front. The front on this Ford emblem is gonna have your forward camera, right? Not only does it have the forward camera, but you got this little trap door, right? So that trap door pops open anytime you hit your windshield wiper, solvent, fluid, boom, your windshield gets clean, but so does your front camera. Makes it kind of nice when you live on a dirt road, like certain people I know. This guy, right? So you can clean that off. So if you are trailing behind someone, even the dirt and debris that's gonna be on a highway or a regular road going down, it's gonna clean all that off for you. Not only did Ford do that, you got LED turn signals, and then you have an LED running light that's gonna go in your headlight too, and then down below, an LED fog to match. So now the carpet matches the drapes. Means everything's LED up front, right? Forward sensing system that's gonna be here as well. Then we're gonna have an adaptive cruise control system as well, which can be custom fitted, right? So how far away do you wanna be from the car in front of you? Well, that can go off of seconds and off of distance. So Ford has got a system that's set up to keep you away from people in front of you, but also do that at a safe traveling distance. And when it's all said and done, you can adjust it to be closer or further away. If you set your cruise control 75 miles an hour, for example, if you get behind somebody who's 62, you're gonna slow down to 62. They get off an exit, then you're behind somebody who's 85. Doesn't mean you're gonna go to 85, just means you're gonna go right back to 75 where you had your cruise control set. Hopefully that makes sense. Four-wheel drive, you're gonna see four-wheel drive. Dead giveaway is gonna be your tow hooks that are in the front of the vehicle too. And we're gonna keep going through some options and keep rolling on through. Big shoes on this vehicle. When it comes from the manufacturer, you've got individual quality testing that's gonna give you a number that's marked on the side of it. These are gonna be wrapped with a Hankook DynaPro HT tire. And yes, those are 22s. You can't lose on 22s. That's what's up. You got a black mirror to match the front grille that's gonna be on the vehicle too, with a blind spot awareness system that's gonna be going into that mirror as well, right? So these are power folding. We'll show you where the amber light is at right here in that location. Also, I do have the key with me. So anytime I grab a door handle, you're gonna have that proximity or that distance to walk up and just do, they call it an intelligent key access. No keys in my hands. Yes, I've got some papers, but I can grab this and you'll see the mirror, the LED turn signal built into your mirror, illuminate anytime I touch it to lock or unlock the vehicle to gain access to it. When we do talk about this vehicle too, you're gonna notice these power deployable running boards. Now that's gonna work for the passenger door or the rear passenger door. I'm gonna let them go up here for a second. Oh, look, I'm gonna get in the back seat. Okay, the kid's got a board too, right? Anybody who's gonna be hopping in the back seat, full size adults comfortably fit in the back of this vehicle without an issue. Look at the size of this door. It's huge. So it's not some little jam people into the back of the seat. It has a huge door, and for a couple different reasons. Mainly, it's gonna be for the access to the third row of this seat, where you can also fit comfortably adults. Let me show you why. The Expedition did a great job of redeveloping the rear suspension of this vehicle too. So if you're looking through, I don't know if you can see it from where we're at, but your pass-through area has this giant circular part built into the frame where your CV axle comes through, and it allows you to move this rear wheel, but lower the seating of the vehicle too, and give you more cargo room and a better cargo entry level. So how high is it to be able to load your luggage, your, you know, everything you need behind that third row seat? Seat sits lower, you got more cargo room, it sits lower, so it's easier to load. Makes sense, right? Built into this back mirror and into the back bumper, I said mirror, tail lights, built into your LED tail light, your LED turn signals, your LED reverse lights. Back here is where your blind spot awareness system is gonna be coming out of that, and you don't even see it. That's a thing that I really like too, is just it's hidden bonuses that you get all the way around on the 2020 Expedition in the Stealth package. A black trim level going, or a little trim piece right here. That says Expedition, that's embossed in there too. Backup camera, again, you're gonna see where our reverse camera is gonna get cleaned off anytime you hit the backup, or the rear windshield cleaning solvent with your windshield wiper here. LED light coming across the top here. Another solvent dispersion coming from right there. Beautiful, right? Easy to see, easy to use. Cool thing that I like on this though too, there's gonna be a couple buttons on the bottom. If you look up on underneath, you've got a button here that's gonna work for being able to release what? Well, that's gonna be here, because guess what? We can actually open our window. That's kind of cool, since some of our competition doesn't do that. That's what I have here documented. Now, this is not the max version. They make two different sizes. This would be in comparison, or the main comparison and competitor that we have here is gonna be the Tahoe, right? So, we've got a difference. Build your spoiler into it. You got your rear windshield built into it, and now you can hit this rear lift gate, and very quickly this goes up, and it's also adjustable. So if you have a garage door and it's too high to lift this in the garage door, you're gonna hit something, right? Well, you can adjust that by pulling it down to wherever's comfortable for you. Now I'm 5'8". If you've got somebody in the family that's shorter than myself or taller than myself, we'll just simply adjust this, right? So I'll put it to right where I want it, press and hold this button. I don't know if you'll hear the ding. Hopefully you heard that ding, but what it'll do is it'll set it to that height. Now you can reset to as high as you want to go with it and just press and hold again. That'll reset the door and the actuator that's lifting and shutting the door to exactly the height that you want it to be. Well, they did a great job by continuing on. We'll just press that button once. The other cool thing is I can actually use my foot when within proximity to lift or shut the door, right? So back here, reverse sensing system underneath the back bottom portion here, we're gonna have this, which is a removable piece to be able to take off and show your rear hitch, right? That rear hitch capability of 9,300 pounds, right? 9,300 pounds. So think about that when you've got a double axle camper that you have more members in the family than just a truck will allow. So 5 passenger, well, we can do 8 passengers in here without a problem. So if you need 8 passengers plus a tow vehicle behind you to be able to go out and go camping and do the things you're gonna do, you've got the ability to do that. We're gonna keep going, and then we'll start going over some more facts too. Capless fuel system is gonna be on the back side of the vehicle too, so you just simply release the nozzle from the pump, put it in, fill it up, off we go, ready to rock and roll. On this vehicle, we happen to have a convenience package too. Part of that convenience package is gonna be having not just the roof rail system, but the crossbars that go with it too. So if you're kayaking, or if you're bringing a additional storage container that can go on the top, whether it's Thule or Yakima, whatever you decide to go with, we do have those available as well in our accessories department. Ford does a great job of making sure they've got plenty of ways for you to put things like J cradles for kayaks, ski and snowboard racks, or storage containers for the whole family to go out and do what they need to do. We're gonna take a look at the back seat real quick, and then we'll keep moving our way around. Back seat on this vehicle, you have an option to go with either a bench or the captain chair setup. So if we go with a bench setup like this, we're gonna see in the Stealth package, you're gonna have not only a leather seat, it's gonna be leather with perforated and contrast stitching. Oh my goodness, look how much contrast stitching is in there. Do you see the red? I mean, you should be like a bull, you know, taking its front leg and tamping at the ground, getting ready to go. There's a lot of red in there, right? But it also just gives it that not boring monochromatic look inside. It really does a great job of separating. Here's a cool thing that I like too. Ford did a great job with taking your rear heating and air and running air vents through, even with this monstrous twin panel moonroof that has a moving first piece of glass and a fixed second piece of glass to really let all the light in and not have that claustrophobic look. Here's a giant handle for us to be able to get in. Now you're gonna wanna see me sit in, and I'm sure, like, how's the legroom look? Oh, it looks great. But you can also see, because it is a stadium seating setup. So now I'm not gonna get car seat by sitting in the second row, because I can still see the road and everything that's coming at me as we're going down the road. So I'm very comfortable to be able to do that. And I've got my rear heating and air. Feels like kind of, I don't know, first class. You might wanna check that out. You can adjust it, right? Also, there's other things that we want to talk about. How about the back of the console? In the back of the console, we've got a 150 watt inverter. Now that's optional on some models, standard on some models, but on this, the Limited, you're going to get this 110 inverter, right? So 110 volt, 150 watts. We've got our heated rear seats, our fan control. We've got our climate control too, which is a digital display here if we've got the vehicle started, along with our media, our clock, and we can even go through and seek plug-in and be able to play with that. On this side, we're going to have dual USB ports here as well. So now if we've got a, what can you charge with a USB? iPad, tablets, whatever you've got going on there, just to keep the people in the second row a little bit more quiet. People, I mean, very little people, like just keep them shut up. You know what I mean? That's what you're gonna get this for. Other things to go for. So if we're not gonna use that second row, it collapses and it does a great job of going flat. So a lot of people, it's manufacturers, right? Manufacturers have this tilt, right? On all of their cargo areas, but it just makes it so annoying because you keep pushing things forward and they keep sliding back. Well, when that's flat, it's beautiful because these seats will do the same thing. Now there's a couple different ways to adjust this seat, and I do want to be able to show you that. So I'm gonna come around over to the other side, show you how some of the handles work. This could be fun. I'll just come right through. So if we come right through here, you've got an adjustment here. First, see that one? So that one's gonna come if we got a car seat in this seat. We can take that and be able to slide the car seat forward without moving the adjustment of the seat itself, giving you a step pad to be able to access into the third row. I'm gonna climb around this thing like a spider monkey. It's gonna be great. Take a look back here. Ugh. Now I'm back in the third row seat with plenty of headroom, plenty of legroom, and we're able to adjust the seats too. What do? They recline. Beautiful, right? Other things that you're gonna pay attention to is things like this. Have you seen a seatbelt that looks like that? Well, if you haven't, this is a rear inflatable seatbelt, which is also gonna come as part of that convenience package we talked about with the top crossbars and roof rail system that you have too. That's one part of it, right? You got the other part of it up top. And then back here, we're able to adjust and recline with our buttons that are, I don't know if you, can you see that here, Jay, by chance? This button?
Yeah.
Here.
Yeah.
How about those? So that's gonna allow me to, oh, hold on. Ready? You ready? Oh. Ready? Here we go again. Wake me up when we're done with the video. Here's the thing, we can fold these completely flat too, but you also have USB charging points for the rear passengers as well with multiple cup holders. Very easy access to get in and out of the vehicle with another grab handle down and over here to help assist you getting in and out of the vehicle. So grab handles on all six passenger areas, right? Four doors, six grab handles, definitely easy to get in and out of the vehicle without a problem. These can fold completely flat too, and they'll fold flat to not have that incline. They'll be completely flat to fold for you, so you can have a huge cargo area. And really, that's like driving a regular cab truck with a topper on it. I mean, you have plenty of room to do whatever you need to do in the back of this vehicle. Let's take a look at the front seat. Give me just a second, and we'll meet you up front. Hey, before we head to the front too, I did want to make sure that we showed you an adjustment. Not only the adjustment of this seat, got some class exclusive things like sliding the seat forward and back. So if the passengers in the back have a little bit longer leg travel and need a little bit more room, we can do that. Huge bolsters on the seat too, and this does tilt as well. Just wanted to make sure you're aware of that. Giant map pocket, contoured seats for the driver and passenger. Now we can take a look at the front. Fair enough, here we go. So when we look in the front of the 2020 Expedition Limited Stealth Package, you're gonna have a first thing you notice is Bang and Olufsen sound system over on that side passenger door. So that B&O CarPlay that you're gonna see over there, that's Bang and Olufsen. Now you got that continued thread going through your dash, through the door panels too. So that contrast stitching that we keep talking about is to make it not seem so plastic, right? So if you're sick of GM doing the same thing they've done for the last 10 years, well, welcome to the new Ford Expedition. This is gonna be a way to change that up. Not only that, we can do things like the heated steering wheel on here with contrast stitching and the black leather wrap steering wheel. We have descent control, which is gonna be pretty much standard across the board now. Ford has just had it out for a minute, right? Lane keeping system, that's gonna be going with us too. And we have the auto start stop. So you can actually just turn that off. If you're sick of your vehicle shutting off at a red light or at a stop sign, then just turn this off. It'll illuminate orange in the off position. And then you're gonna have your camera adjustment too. We'll show you that in just a few minutes. There's a lot more buttons and gadgets inside of this vehicle. And standard is going to be our push button start with the 3.5 liter EcoBoost engine putting out more torque and horsepower than any competition in their V8s. And we're going to probably do better gas mileage too, because I drove one of these doing 23.7 miles per gallon highway travel at 72 miles an hour with my cruise control set. Look forward to that, because that doesn't really happen in vehicles of this size. A lot more extra things to go. We've got our 12 volt outlet that's going to be here. We have a reverse backup system too, so that's trailer guidance, or reverse backup trailer guidance knob here, right? So what that's gonna do is, once we have a trailer paired to this vehicle, up to 10 different trailers, you'll pick what trailer you want on your LCD productivity screen up front in front of the steering wheel. You'll just push on, and then you're able to steer your vehicle in reverse with just using this guide knob here, right? So this dial will literally back your vehicle up. If you leave it alone in this position, you can literally back up straight without jackknifing your vehicle. 4 miles, if you had to do it, you could do it in this vehicle. Other things that I like are just some of the small things, like extra storage. That looks great. This came out of the Super Duty that we developed in 2017, is a second storage area up here by your glove box. So you got your top one up here. This is a little bit more classy design than what they did in the Super Duty. Super Duty is pretty much silver. And then down here, massive storage area. Your owner's manual can go up there. Our keyless entry card, which you're gonna see on Ford vehicles, that's gonna come with it as well. So guess what? If you do go boating, if you do go out and you're using an ATV or using a side-by-side, whatever you're using, you don't need to bring your keys with you. You can lock them in your vehicle, easy peasy, right? You're gonna see my iPhone stored down here. Where my iPhone is, behind that, is this charging system, right? So you're gonna have that in vehicles like the Explorer, in the Expedition, in the Super Duties, in the F-150s, in these higher trim levels like this, the Limited Stealth Package 2020 Expedition. You're gonna have that, right? Other things that I like too. So if I'm driving down the road, and I'm gonna show you this, this is a really cool button, right? But we start the vehicle, I'm going down the road. I don't have anybody in my third row, but my visibility isn't the best that you can see, right? We're just gonna simply hit this button right here, which is above my left knee, and it'll drop my headrests. So this button right here, and then you're gonna wanna see the headrest in the back. Boom, see them drop down? That is sick, right? So now I can see out that window, that huge window that you've got on this vehicle, that's with the seats up. Now those seats can fold completely flat if you need a little bit better visibility, yet you can definitely do that without an issue. Trailer brake controller, gain and output system, that's ready to go for trailer brakes that you're gonna have on a tow vehicle behind you. Shut some of these things up and give my camera guy some room. This is gonna be our Sync 3 system, version 4 of our Sync 3. We're gonna take a look at some dots, right? So if we have dots down here, that just means we can slide over. There's more presets to come, right? This is our audio. We can go over to our phone. We can go to our navigation system. The thing I do like about the new navigation system is it'll not only tell you what the miles per hour are, if we're on a road, we're in a parking lot, but if we're on a road, it'll show our miles per hour or our speed limit on this vehicle. Now, Co-Pilot Assist, which is what we have on this vehicle, will also read stop sign, or will read your speed limit signs. Are you serious right now? Yes, it reads it. So it'll reflect back and make sure that you're going the proper speed limit for the vehicle. We can always go back to our home screen here just by hitting your home button up on the top. We can go to our applications. We can go over to settings. We can be able to go, there's two more dots, so we know we've got a room to slide our Wi-Fi connection. You'll have an ESN number available with your Stealth 2020 Expedition. What you're gonna do with that is $20 a month through AT&T. You can have a Wi-Fi hotspot for the vehicle itself instead of your phone. You can do one or the other or both, but this will allow up to 10 devices within 50 feet to be able to pair to the vehicle. So when you go camping, or if you go out fishing, or if you go out hunting, or if you go out doing whatever you're gonna do in a vehicle of this caliber, you're gonna have Wi-Fi going with you. So internet, not gonna be something that's gonna make the kids all irritated, because you know how they are nowadays, right? So let's take a look at our screen up here, over by where our speedometer and where all of our adjustments are, our tach. So what we're gonna do through this screen is just simply hit the OK button. It's telling me that my vehicle, that I've got the doors open. So this is trip one, and then we've got fuel economy. We've got our off-road settings. On the off-road settings, we're gonna see what our wheels are adjusted at. So if you back a trailer in and you're going to a campground, we're at 16 degrees, that's how you backed it in. That's how you pull it out and make sure you don't hit the tree that's hugging it tight. Now, if we go over, we're gonna have a trip and fuel economy setting as well. That's gonna go trip one, trip two. Your fuel economy set by a bar graph in increments of 5 to 15 minutes. Keep going. where you've got another gauge view. Now this is gonna be your tire pressure, your digital speedometer, because people do wanna see how fast they're going without having to look at a gauge. My God, how convenient have we made it. Towing, all right, so towing status. It'll also say towing information. This is really cool, because the other day when I hooked up to my trailer, it told me that my left turn signal on my trailer was out. So that just makes it so much easier. $1.19 bulb's way better than getting pulled over and having to deal with getting an inconvenience and an interruption in your trip. Off-road setting, again, is gonna show us our yaw pitch movement and the degree of turn for our front wheels as well. Blind spot awareness that we've talked about earlier. This isn't just going to be for the vehicle, it's also going to be for the tow vehicle behind you. Cross traffic alert, if you're at a parking spot and you're backing out of Neiman's Market and you've got somebody sharking your spot, they're going to tell you left or right if that person's coming trying to pick up where you're at. Even if you do try to park next to a Pinto and a Yugo next to you so you can see everything around you, when you come out and you got somebody with a truck on both sides, now you can see better. Driver's alert, we turn that on and off. What that's gonna be is part of that same lane keeping system, just to make sure that driver's alert is there. So if you're fading in and out of your lane, it's gonna even tell you to grab a cup of coffee. Our gauge selection, pardon me. It'll show us our turbo, the amount of boost that we have going on, or it'll show us our, and it'll show us our trans temp, and then we keep on going, right? So those are options. You can always go back to the star, which is your first my view, and set up exactly the way you want your display to be. That's a lot. I'm still holding. Here we go. Woof, right? Love it. Other things that you're gonna look at on here is gonna go, okay, so we've got our cruise control set up here. When we're talking about the distance of travel on your adaptive cruise control, this is to shorten the distance, this is to gain distance, right? So this is gonna be an adjustment on your cruise control. That's when it's gonna be active as well. Auto high beams, right? High beams will come on whenever you don't have somebody coming down the road at you to reflect light back into the camera system that's above your rearview mirror. The other part of that too is, it's got auto sensing wipers. It starts raining, it starts wiping, and your lights automatically come on. You really don't need to do anything but steer it in the direction you want to go. Pretty awesome. I mean, they really thought of a lot of good options in here. Let's get back over to this climate control system too, because there's multiple ways to control this. The thing I do like here versus like a Super Duty Lariat right now is you actually have a digital display of where your fan speed is at, and they make a little bit bigger button to be able to adjust that. I do like that a bit more than what's on the Super Duty now. It's convenient either way, easy to find. This one's just a little bit easier to find than the Super Duty. You got your max, defrost. You got defrost here, you've got your auto setting, heated steering wheel here, max AC over here, AC, rear defrost. Oh, here we go, we keep going. Rear, this is gonna be the rear control areas for up here on your rear climate control. That'll then display up top, and that can be controlled beyond that console where we showed it to you a little bit earlier on the back side of it. You can control it there, or you can control it here if you wanna close that out to the kids behind you if they're touching too many buttons, right? That's another option. Here we go, let's keep going. On this one, we're gonna have a tilt and telescopic. It's power, I'm not having to adjust anything. I don't really have to do a whole lot there, right? Once I get it set right where I wanna set this steering column that's power controlled, right? Then I'm just gonna take this door and I'm gonna hit number 1, 2, or 3 for driver 1, 2, or 3. Press and hold. Let's see if we can hear the beep together. That beep means, I don't know if you heard that. If you did, it goes beep, right? Simple as that. That's driver 1, then driver 2, then driver 3. So all of these can be set once you get your spot right where it is, where you want to drive, totally comfortable. I did have a customer that picked up an Expedition not too long ago, but he goes, you know what, I want to make sure that I've got a place to put my left leg comfortably. Well, they've got a stop part here, but he likes to put it right there next to the speaker. Well, I mean, there's all kinds of areas to just really sit wide and comfortably in here. Things I want to talk about also are going to be like your normal pistol grip shifter. Not anymore, we've got this. We're in park, we're in drive, neutral, reverse, and then we can even go to a manual system, right? So the manual mode is going to allow you to shift, but when we go to our reverse, for example, that's going to show us our backup camera. Now, that's our reverse camera. If we want to see a full reverse camera, we'll touch one side. We can also zoom in and zoom into our dynamic hitch assist. Now that's where your hitch is gonna be. So you'll see your receiver coming out with a chrome ball and be able to back up to the tongue of that trailer very easily, right? Now our sensing system, if you see the vehicle here, our sensing system is gonna be all the way around on Expedition Limited in the stealth package, right? So we can zoom in, we can zoom out. We also have a bird's eye view over on this side. If you follow my finger up here, is going to be our camera system. So this is to back up. This is going to be our 180 degree backup. So it gives you three different screens, right? And then if we hit it again, it goes back to our normal system. If we go into drive and then I hit that same camera button up here, it's going to show me a forward facing camera. The forward facing camera still gives me that 360 view, but now it's going to also show me the red F-150 with a capper on it that is right in front of me to not be able to hit that vehicle too. We'll hit it one more time, gives me a full front screen. If I hit it one more time, it gives me that 180 angle in the front as well. How many cameras do you need? Feels like I'm driving the Paparazzi 2020 model. Got them all, right? So that's what I want to take a look at too, is just making sure you know about options that are inside of the vehicle and how to use them. Other things is, let's look up top. We got our sunglasses holder. Cool, gotta have them. Your little Maui Jims or your Costas or your Ray-Bans or whatever are up there. We've got our control for opening the sunroof here. This is gonna control our shades, right map light, left map light. This is gonna be to turn on and off the lights once the door or the entry of the vehicle. So if you crack the door open, boom, it turns on all the light. We've got a nice bug screen that's up here too, and that keeps a lot of the wind noise down as well. I'm trying to think of what they haven't thought of, and it sounds like they've thought of them all. Huge console, so you're not fighting over giving me arm space, right? Like you're hopping into a coach sheet in 747 doing your thing, right? But then you pop this thing open, and inside of here is this massive vault of space, right? Just huge. And then you've got this storage tray that slides back and forth, holds coins, business card holders, all that good stuff inside of there, but also doubles as a file hanger. So if you are doing business out of the vehicle, real estate agent, whatever you are, you can hold all of those different things in here, MLS listings, whatever you've got going on, or deals being pended. If that's personal information, you also have a locking access to this from your key as well. So let's pull that key out. Here's what it looks like. Here's gonna be your panic alarm. Let me hold it the right side up. Panic alarm, this is to lift and shut your lift gate. This is your remote start for Ford. You have to lock first, then remote start button twice. That'll start the vehicle, lock the vehicle, unlock the vehicle as well. And you're gonna be able to depress this button right here. I don't know if you can see that. But once you push that in, you can pull that key out. When that key is out, it can go in and be able to do things like lock this console. That's what I'm talking about, is locking it and being able to go, now I can't access it. If there is personal information in there, then you can do all that. Now it's unlocked, here we go, off to the races, right? So many different options with the 2020 Expedition, and especially in the stealth mode, giving you the unbelievable appearance package with all the red stitching on the inside, looking absolutely beautiful. Let's take a look underneath the hood and we'll wrap this thing up for you. Ready? Let's go. Hey, let's wrap it up by taking a look underneath the hood of the 2020 Expedition. This is going to be the 3.5 liter EcoBoost. When it's a 3.5 liter, it's a twin turbo EcoBoost engine. Now, Ford has been producing this engine since 2011. In the Expedition, it's been out since 2015. Things that I like about this Expedition and this power plant that's underneath this hood is it's super easy to see all your clear storage containers and reservoirs. Let's just talk about that. You saw me carrying these papers earlier, right? 375 horsepower, 470 pound foot of torque. Well, that's more than all of our competition. That's including the 5.3 liter that you're gonna find in your Tahoe, and you're gonna find that in your Yukon. Well, instead of our 375, you're gonna have 355. That's a downgrade, right? Then we have 470 pound foot of torque versus their 383. So we've got almost 100 pound foot of torque more. Why do you think we can haul 9,300 pounds and blow the doors off of that vehicle next to you hauling the same weight, but ours is just a little bit better and doing it a lot more efficiently. So taking a look at what this Expedition has to offer, take a look at some specs yourself. Take a look at videos like this and we'll back them all up. Leave a comment, like it, subscribe it. Any questions that you have, we're more than happy to answer. This is us here at Lasco Ford shooting another video on the 2020 Expedition. We've got more of them coming at you. As vehicles come out, you're gonna see more. If you subscribe, you're gonna see those first and foremost, firsthand. This is Paul Zagman here at Lasco Ford in Fenton, Michigan. Give us a call at 810-629-2255. Or go to Lasco Ford, L-A-S-C-O, LascoFord.com. See all of our inventory that we've got available for you immediately. And we do ship anywhere in the United States. So keep us in mind. We appreciate it. Thanks for watching.